As Delir drilled for the meteor, Trumorcliff's last letter reverberated in his mind. Trumorcliff thought his death was actually a rebirth through the meteor's power. Obviously, he had been insane, but what had he been trying to communicate? One thing was clear. Trumorcliff had renounced his old mind and embraced genius. The Pinkertons shouted. They spotted a horde of armed madmen, Turner's minions. Insane or not, Trumorcliff had known what must be done. Now, it was Delir's turn. emerged from the crater, the meteor tucked under his coat. The steam carriage was his only means of escape. Mr. Persons swore he would get Delir out alive.
Thank you.
Fear was putting the final touches on his masterpiece when the madmen closed in. If he could get power to the machine, it would invert the meteor's energy. It might cure them, it might kill them. Either way, it would stop them. Swore, spat blood. He cursed Delir once more and died. Solomon restored partial power, but not enough to start the device. Trimmercliff froze and fell to the ground, dead. Solomon restored full power. The machine came to life on its own. Suddenly, a blinding flash suffused the battlefield, along with a thunderous blast. The power of the meteor, now inverted, invaded every mind in the area. All in the vicinity were cleansed of madness, but in its place, only blanks remained. Some awoke as from a bad dream, others stared emptily. Several dropped dead. Over the next few weeks, Pinkertons appeared by the dozen to help rebuild the town. The crisis was over. Delir vowed to protect the machine until it was needed again.